Hello everyone, my name is Sapna. I am a mentor working with one of the SRLMs.
Hello everyone, I am Kusum. I am a Vitta Sakhi and I am supported by my mentor, Sapna Madam.
NRLM has taken the initiative of supporting women entrepreneurs in SHGs for individual enterprise loans. I and my Vitta Sakhi Kusum will discuss about different aspects related to this initiative, and we hope that you all will also find our conversations helpful. So, let's start.
Banks' loan evaluation parameters and identification of entrepreneurs for bank loans, Part 1. Hello everyone. Since this topic is a bit long, we will have this video in two parts. In this part of the video, we will learn about the loan evaluation parameters of banks, importance of credit history in loan evaluation, and importance of personal qualities and capacity of entrepreneur in loan evaluation.
Sapna Madam, why is it important for Vitta Sakhis to know about banks' loan evaluation parameters? How will it help us in our work?
See Kusum, it is important for Vitta Sakhis as they will be responsible to identify the potential entrepreneurs for bank loans. If Vitta Sakhis understand banks' loan evaluation parameters, they will be in a better position to identify and select right kind of entrepreneurs who are more likely to qualify bank's loan appraisal process. Hence, it is important for Vitta Sakhis to be familiar with the bank's loan evaluation criteria.
Madam, which kind of entrepreneurs in terms of loan requirements should we focus on?
See Kusum, this initiative of NRLM is focused on women entrepreneurs who need larger loans, that is, at least above Rs 75,000 and are going up to Rs 10 lakh. So Vitta Sakhis should focus on identifying entrepreneurs having such loan requirements and the ability to repay these loans.
Madam, what do banks look at while evaluating a loan proposal?
Absolutely, Kusum. Let's talk about it.
For evaluating any loan proposal, banks focus on four main parameters: credit history of the entrepreneur, personal qualities and capacity of the entrepreneur, household financial condition of the entrepreneur, and performance of the business for which the loan is applied. First, let's talk about credit history. Banks do not lend any individual who has either defaulted on a loan or has a history of irregular repayment in the past loans. On the other hand, if anyone has history of regular repayment of past loans, then banks are favorably inclined to give loans to such customers.
But madam, how will banks know from where one borrowed and how one repaid the loan? I mean, one can borrow from one bank and then go to another.
Good point, Kusum. I will tell you.
Banks check the credit history of a customer through credit bureaus. Credit bureaus are companies that keep the records of all loans from formal sources and they share this data with their member financial institutions. There are four credit bureaus in India. These are CIBIL, Experian, Highmark, and Equifax. Based on credit history, they provide a credit score to the customer in the range of 300 to 900. Banks generally lend to customers with credit score of over 700. Whenever a customer applies for loan, bank first checks the credit score of the customer through these credit bureaus.
Banks check the credit history of the borrower, which is an important part of loan evaluation. So, Vitta Sakhi should ensure that the applicant does not have any default history.
Good Sapna Madam, I understood the importance of credit history in loan appraisal and how it is checked by banks. Now, can you explain what banks look at in terms of personal qualities and capacity of the entrepreneur?
Sure Kusum. Let us discuss the personal qualities and capacity of the entrepreneur that banks check during loan evaluation.
Banks generally like to lend to individuals who they think have the personal capacity to run a business and have good overall reputation in the society. This means that the person should be in the age category where she can run a business effectively. She has the ability and confidence to go out and talk to people, has ability to give enough time to business, has good understanding and experience of her business, and is not dependent on others for decision making. If the entrepreneur has some training or qualification in the subject of her business, it gives extra comfort to banks. Banks may also check the reputation of the entrepreneur in the society by talking to the neighbors, suppliers, or others who might know the applicant. It is therefore recommended that initially, Vitta Sakhis should focus on identifying entrepreneurs with at least 2 years of experience in the business. Due to gender issues existing in the society, many women could face constraints. Hence, Vitta Sakhi should focus on identifying women entrepreneurs who have the confidence, decision-making ability, and the ability to give time to business. Vitta Sakhis should also constantly support women entrepreneurs in building their capacities and confidence.
Sapna Madam, there are many women whose husbands do the business and the women just support. Can we identify such women too for loan process?
Kusum, it is very important that Vitta Sakhis identify women entrepreneurs who are involved in the businesses or at least participate significantly in the business, even if they run it jointly with their male family members. Vitta Sakhis should ensure that women do not merely become a channel to get loans for businesses. NRLM wants to support women to become entrepreneurs and to manage large businesses.
Understood, madam. I had one more doubt. Does bank give full loan amount as needed by the entrepreneur?
Kusum, banks generally expect entrepreneur to also contribute around 10 to 15% of the capital required. Bank wants to see if the entrepreneur is committed to the business and is also willing to bear the risk by putting her own money in the business or not. Hence, Vitta Sakhis should keep this ability to give margin money also in mind while identifying entrepreneurs for bank loan.
Thanks, Sapna Madam, for explaining the loan evaluation parameters of bank, importance of credit history, and the importance of personal qualities and capacity of entrepreneur in loan appraisal. I think this much is enough for today.
Yes, Kusum. Next time, we will understand the other two loan appraisal criteria on household analysis and business analysis for loan appraisal.
Sure, madam. Thank you.